Hi, Drew. We have your 1972 280 SEL 4.5 on the hoist. Just wanted to show you what the car is going to need. The muffler has some holes in it, and I'm pointing out right now where one of the holes is on the muffler. It has another hole here, and it has another hole here. So there's, you know, three small holes in the rear muffler. Eventually, this muffler will need to be replaced. The other thing I want to show you is under the car. The rear differential has some minor seepage, which is normal for a car this age. Right there is where the seepage is in the rear differential, and it still has the original spring compensator on it. Eventually, it will need to be updated. The spring compensators, they generally do go bad and cause the rear suspension to sag when they go bad, but this one is original, and you don't need to do anything about it now. I just wanted to point out to you that it's still the original spring compensator. The other thing I want to point out to you is that these tires are really old, and they're going to need to be replaced. All four tires are more than 10 years old, so you're going to need all four tires. The tire that's actually leaking is the left rear tire, which is this one right here, and it's leaking right where this red mark is. So you're going to need to replace all four wheels. The rear resonator also has a hole right around this area of the connection pipe, so it's going to need to have the rear resonator just maybe patched up right there. I think it can be fixed. It's no big deal. The other thing we're going to show you is that the transmission pan has a very minor seepage around the pan, and that's because the car has been sitting for a long time. It's normal that the transmission pans have some seepage when the car sits for a long time. So I would recommend, if you want it to stop leaking, maybe just put a new pan gasket, and that's all it's going to need. But the pan gasket itself is causing the transmission pan to remain wet. The next thing we're going to show you is that the tie rods are worn out. And over here you can see that this tie rod boot is broken. So you need to do something about this tie rod boot. All the tie rods, boots on the tie rods are worn out, and all four tie rods should be replaced. So and then after that's done, you're going to need a wheel alignment. The next thing we're going to show you is that the subframe mounts for the front suspension, they're also worn out. So you can see that the front suspension subframe mounts are going to need attention. This is something that you should do if you don't want the front suspension to rattle. I'm pointing it out to you with my finger. You can see right here that the right front suspension subframe is worn out. I'm going to show you the left side right now. I'm going to go to the other side. And you can see right here that the left front suspension subframe mount is also collapsed and causing the front suspension to make noise when you go over big bumps. The power steering gearbox has some very minor sweating, and again, this is kind of normal for a car that sits a long time. So it's not leaking any oil. It's just has some, you know, seepage, which could happen from a car that just sits too much. So, you know, just want to point that out to you. The other thing we're going to point out to you is there is a minor drip coming down the left front sway bar area because the power steering pump is starting to leak. So it's going to need to, the power steering pump is leaking oil, and it's going to need some attention. I'm trying to point it out to you, but if you can see that small drop leaking off the case of the power steering pump, that's where the oil leak is on the power steering pump. The other thing we wanted to point out is that this fuel filter looks like it's really old, so we're recommending that the fuel filter be replaced, as well as some of these fuel lines. They're starting to crack. The fuel lines themselves are going to need attention when the fuel filter is replaced. The next thing I want to show you is that the AC compressor is actually rubbing on the front sway bar. The motor mounts are low on the car and causing the AC compressor to touch the front sway bar, and the belt's starting to deteriorate because of that. You can see the fraying being done on the AC belt. The belt is also starting to crack, so it's going to need a new AC belt, and it's also going to need to have the motor mounts replaced because the compressor is touching on the front sway bar because the motor mounts are collapsing. So you definitely need motor mounts, and you're going to need a new AC belt. And then the engine oil pan is bent. It has damage. It looks like they may have accidentally run over a parking stop in a parking lot, and the engine rested on the parking stop. So it's going to need a new engine oil pan as well. Next thing we're going to show you is that the front license plate bracket is not there. It needs a front license plate bracket, and it's also going to need the two horns. The two horns were stolen off the car. They're kind of collectible. People like the way they sound. So what people do is they steal them and they cut them off the car. And you know, these horns are rare, are very hard to find, and they're expensive now. So I just want to point out that you're going to need the original horns for this car. we're still in the front area of the engine, and I wanted to point out that this hose here that comes all the way down, this upper oil cooler hose, is starting to sweat quite a bit, and I'm worried that it could leak at any time. So I recommend that you replace the upper oil cooler hose. You can actually kind of see that it's uneven in this area, and that's probably where the point of leak is going to start if we don't address this hose soon. So I recommend replacing it. On the front suspension sway bar links, the bushings for the sway bar right here, you can see they're starting to crack. So the front sway bar link bushings are going to need to be replaced. And also the front engine shock mount, the bushings for the engine shock are also starting to deteriorate and come apart. So the left front engine shock mount is going to need some new bushings as well, and we will check the shock at the same time to see if it's fatigued or worn out. Drew, a couple things we want to point out cosmetically about the car is that the front hood star is missing. It's going to need a new hood star. The other thing that's not right with the car is that the wiper blades are aftermarket, and because they worn out, they scratched the window. I don't know if you can see the scratch, but the window is scratched, so this would either need to be polished or the windshield's going to need to be replaced, and that's the only way you can get rid of these scratches. The other thing I want to point out is that the front antenna mast is broken, so it's going to need a new manual antenna, or you can put an automatic one in if you'd like. Drew, the other thing that just happened, we put the car down on the lift and the tire and the left rear lost all its air from that hole that I pointed out to you earlier. The other thing is that there's some body damage right here on the left rear door. There's a big dent in this area right here. I'm going to go around the dent, but there's a big dent. You can't really see on camera, but there is a big dent on the left rear door, and there's a minor dent right here on the left rear quarter panel. The other thing I wanted to show you on the roof molding, the roof molding is broken right here in this area. It's missing a big piece of roof molding, so you'll need to replace this roof line molding. It's going to need to be a complete piece. On the rear trunk panel, it's been keyed. There's a huge key mark here, and there's a huge key mark here. So someone keyed the trunk panel. The trunk panel is going to need to be repainted. We opened up the hood, and we just wanted to show you that the hood insulation pad is missing. It's going to need a hood insulation pad. Also, the battery is the wrong size battery. It's going to need a larger size battery. This battery is too small, so we recommend putting the correct size battery so that it could be held down properly, because the battery bracket is actually all the way back there and the battery doesn't even reach it. So the battery is just really loose and it should be replaced with the correct size battery. The other thing I want to point out is that the wood grain panel on the dash is all ruined because the weather strip seal on the front windshield is allowing water to come in. But to be honest, this happens whether or not the weather strip is sealed is new or not. These wood grain panels absorb all the water and moisture from the windshield seal, so you can see that the front wood is going to need to be replaced. Also, the dash varnish would need to be redone. It's all kind of weathered and cracked. So if you want the dash wood to be redone, you would need to do that. And then the final thing is that the wood grain on the doors is also deteriorating. It is going to need some attention too. But you can see the wood grain on the wood on the doors is going to need attention. These wood pieces all go bad because when water gets on them, they get ruined. So most of the door seals are okay, but some of them are cracking on the ends. So the weather strip seals are going to need some attention in the future. But they do, for the most part, for the age of the car, they are seem to be working and are pretty much intact except for on the corners. The heater handles, they're supposed to be intact and they're all broken. This is quite a job to do. I would recommend that you upgrade these to metal if you were to replace them. So you're going to need the metal heater handles on this car if you don't want them to break in the future. The plastic rubber style ones break all the time after a few short years. So I recommend that you go ahead and have these replaced with metal units. The car has the wrong gas cap. It's not a Mercedes cap, it's a domestic aftermarket style cap, so it's going to need the correct style gas cap for the fuel tank. This spare tire is flat. It actually has no air in it, so it's going to need five tires. And for the most part, looking through the trunk, everything seems to be rust free. I would recommend though that you do replace the trunk weather strip because it is deteriorating. It's starting to fall apart. So the fact that the trunk has not that much rust is going to be short-lived if this trunk seal isn't replaced. So I would recommend changing the trunk seal. And we looked underneath the car, And we really didn't see that much rust. We didn't see any rust, to be honest with you. The car is very clean. There's no rust that I can see.